Well, here are Michelle and myself ready for a dolphin dive. Should be quite interesting. They have two bottlenose dolphins that they keep in a pen at night, but they let them out into open ocean for our dive. And they are free to go back to the ocean if they want, but they always choose to come back. Here are the two dolphins. They were pretty terrific. You have to remember that dolphins are mammals, and they evolve from bear-like animals that were land animals about 125 million years ago. And they went into the water because there was more food in the water. And eventually, they turned into dolphins, which, like I said before, are mammals. Don't forget, mammals breathe air. They're warm-blooded. They have live young. So there I am with, I have a camera that's on the floor. It's on the floor of the ocean. I'm petting the dolphin. The dolphin is about 450 pounds. There's my camera. And I believe the next person the dolphin's gonna go to is my wife. So we'll see, but they're very smooth, not like sharks. Sharks have skin that are made of teeth. So let's see if the dolphin goes to my wife. Yep, there's Michelle. And now she is petting the dolphin, very smooth skin. Now, as the dolphin goes to the other people, you have to remember that dolphins echolocate their food, just like bats do, which means they send out high-frequency noises, and if the prey is around, the high-frequency noises will bounce back to the dolphin or bat, and they will know exactly the location of its prey. So that is called echolocation. Thank you. people always think that dolphins can attack and kill sharks. Well, only in very rare circumstances will that happen. If the dolphin is protecting its baby, then it will go and attack the sharks, and it will ram them in the gills to try to kill them. But usually the sharks, if there's quite a few around and there's only a dolphin or two around, the sharks will attack and kill the dolphin. Bottlenose dolphins usually live in groups, somewhere between 10 and 50 members, and the group is called a pod. But the size can vary up to 1,000 dolphins. And you know, the diet is usually food. And amazingly enough, the dolphins work together as a team to corral the fish, which is pretty amazing. And like I said before, they use echolocation. So the sound bounces off the fish and the dolphin knows it is close by. One of the deepest dives that a bottlenose dolphin has ever been recorded at was almost 1,000 feet, which is like a 100-story building. That's pretty deep. And they know that they can live up to 60 years old, which is another amazing feat. The next thing that we're going to be talking about is the dolphins have an incredibly large brain, second only to humans. So the great apes and dolphins have the second largest brain of anything on Earth, including people. So people have the smartest, and then the dolphins and the great apes are the second smartest. Another interesting feature about dolphins and also whales is their tail. Their tail is horizontal to the bottom of the ocean, while all other fish, their tails are vertical. So that's something unique to dolphins and whales, which are mammals. Also, they can hold their breath for about 20 minutes. And usually rise to the surface so 2 or 3 times a minute to breathe. So that should ask you a question about how they sleep. So this is how they sleep. It's called half sleep. Half of their brain remains active and half shuts down to sleep. And they just lay near the surface, going up and breathing and just coming back down. And they sleep for about 8 hours a day, which is kind of just like what humans should do. And that's me. That's the dolphin spun me around just a little bit ago. Now the dolphin is spinning Michelle around. It was a really weird sensation. Remember, dolphins are mammals, so they give birth to live young. Humans have a 9-month period, but dolphins have a gestation period of 12 months before the baby dolphin is born. There have been many reports of dolphins helping people. Sometimes they help fishermen by corralling the fish in the nets, and the fish that escape, the dolphins get to eat. But one amazing thing that happened was near New Zealand, where 4 swimmers were being stalked by a great white shark, and several dolphins came in, they corralled the people, and they would not let the shark come in and attack the people. That was very interesting. Dolphins are fairly fast animals. They can swim between 25 and 30 miles an hour. And that is fast for a sea creature. Now the dolphins are kissing, and that's me. And the dolphin kissed me twice. I was real excited. But when it kisses my wife, I think it kisses her 3 times. Didn't want to leave. 1, 2, and 1 more time, and then it went away. So she got 3 kisses from the dolphin. As you can see, the dolphins went up to the surface and jumped right out of the water. Now what they're doing is they're waving goodbye to all of us with their pectoral fins. This was a really cool encounter. They were great dolphins. The next thing we did was a shark dive. Two totally different animals. Remember, dolphins are mammals. Warm-blooded, give birth to live young, and breathe air. Sharks are fish. Now, sharks have been around for 450 million years. That's an incredibly long time. They were here 200 million years before dinosaurs ever walked the earth. That's pretty an astounding fact. So sharks have had time to develop into the ultimate predator. And here you see we're getting ready for our shark dive. So before we get into the water, I have to tell you a little bit more about sharks. Like I said, they are the ultimate predator. They have at least five senses that home in on their prey. The first sense is the sense of smell. They have a spectacular sense of smell. They can smell a drop of blood in an Olympic-sized swimming pool. So they can smell about a pint of blood about a quarter of a mile away. And hammerheads have the best ability to smell because their nose is so far apart on their hammerhead. And one thing you have to remember is the largest predator in the world ever was a shark. It was Megalodon, 65 feet long, able to swallow a horse standing up. Absolutely ferocious. Its diet was whole whales. But as the water turned colder, the megalodons died off and their little cousins took over, which were the great whites. Now, we are about ready to enter the water. And what you see is a man starting to feed Caribbean reef sharks. He is in a chain mail suit. That is like a suit that the knights in the old days wore. You see the chain mail? So if the shark bites him, it will crush the muscle and bone, but it won't rip the skin and muscle open. Now, these are typical, like I said, Caribbean reef sharks. You are going to see some nurse sharks in there also. The yellowfish you see right now are called yellowtail snappers. So he is feeding the sharks, and they are getting extremely close. So what are we doing while he is feeding the sharks? Well, we are in a row and we're kind of linking hands. The man you see in the background has a bang stick. That bang stick has a shotgun shell at the end. And if the shark gets too aggressive, that guy right there, if the shark gets too aggressive, he'll hit it with a bang stick and kill it. So here we are. We are very close to each other, so the sharks cannot slide between us. So everybody has a little bit overweight so we can kneel at the bottom of the ocean. There's about 15 of us, and I'll show you Michelle and myself. We're coming up shortly. We're at the almost at the very end of the group. So we're all about 10 feet away from the feeding. So we're getting real close to the end. And there's my wife, Michelle, and there's me. And then we have a couple more people, and then the armed dive master. And there's the armed dive master in a chainmail suit. Now, what he's doing is he's trying to put the shark to sleep. And usually if you rub their bellies or rub their noses, like this guy's doing, they'll stop moving and they'll kind of fall asleep. But I would not recommend to do that for anybody. See, what he's doing is he tries to hold the nose and then the shark just kind of gets very docile, almost very sleepy. Now here is a nurse shark coming up on the bottom. Right there. The one coming up there is a nurse shark. You can see the barbels in his front mouth and the shape is way different. So let's start talking a little bit about the shark's senses. The sharks, we already talked about their sense of smell is fabulous. Now see, that's a stingray and that's some of the shark's most favorite food that's going by right now. So sharks have a NASA grouper. They're big and they like the food that the dive master's giving the sharks also. Now the sharks are starting to swirl. There's us right there. We're in one line so the sharks cannot go between us. So the next sense the sharks have is their teeth. If they lose two or three teeth biting down on something, no big deal, because they have 5, 6, 7, 8 rows of teeth. So as soon as they lose a couple teeth, the next day a few pop up. They can produce 10,000 teeth in their lifetime. So they're like tooth factories. The next thing they have is their skin. Their skin is very smooth if you pet them from head to tail. But if you pet them from tail to head, it will take the skin off your hand because shark skin is made of little teeth. They are called dermal denticles. And in the old days, shark skin was used for sandpaper. It was that rough. Now, I don't know if you can see it or not, but as the sharks come in, they have this membrane that closes over their eye. It looks white. And why it closes over their eye? So it protects their eye from being punctured. There's so many sharks around, it's very difficult to see, but as the shark comes in for food, this membrane will close the eye completely and it'll look totally white. Their eyesight is excellent. They can see reflections. So, if you're at the surface and they look up, they can absolutely see a reflection of you up there. So their eyesight is quite good. They also have this crazy sense that is called ampullae of Lorenzini, and they're little teeny holes in their nose, and they can detect electrical impulses from fish's muscles, and that's how they can detect stingrays buried under the sand. They can detect all these electrical impulses. So they don't really have to see their prey. They know it's there from these little ampullae of Lorenzini. Pretty amazing. And sound. They can really hear sound quite well from at maybe 10, 20, 30, 40 miles away. During World War II, explosions would draw all the sharks in and then they would start feeding. Now notice that this water is extremely clear. This is the type of water, if you're swimming in the ocean, you want to swim in clear ocean water. Because if it's muddy and cloudy, that's a problem because sharks normally don't bite people. But if they can't see them very well through the cloudiness, they may think you're a fish and bite you. So never ever swim in the ocean where a river or a creek empties out. because it will be very muddy and absolutely not good. And the number one shark that attacks people usually love to swim in muddy water near rivers. And the number one shark that attacks people is called a bull shark. They have more shark attacks on record than any other shark, including the great white, the hammerhead, the tiger, the oceanic white tip, all of those sharks. Nothing compares to the bull sharks. They're very aggressive. So if you are snorkeling or scuba diving and you encounter a shark, usually it's no big deal. But if the shark starts arching its back and swaying back and forth very quickly and making quick turns, that means it wants you out of its territory immediately. And definitely swim away, because that means that a shark attack is imminent. So here we're just showing everybody in the row, and you can see some of the sharks are in the background, some are in the front, so they're all over the place, but we're still keeping the chainmail guys. There's one of them, and they are just protecting us. And that's how it works. That's all of us. Notice this man has a double tank. Usually we only have single tanks. And his hoses are protected with little steel covering, like his chainmail suit protects his body. So he has just almost run out of food, and the sharks are still swirling around. And once in a while you can see their eyes, that white membrane, closing in, and so it's helped to protect his eyes. Now notice some of the sharks are getting a little aggressive, and that's not really good. You can see from the view from above how the sharks are swirling around. It's a little dangerous. I would definitely not feed sharks like that. And there we are to the left, and we are really holding tight so the sharks cannot go through us. Pretty interesting view of the sharks. Now look at the sharks cruising around us. Yeah, it started to get kind of confusing because there were so many sharks. And you can see they're hanging around the bait canister right there. I'm just waiting to see if you can see its eye. There, a little bit of the eye you saw. The white membrane close shut around the eye, usually when they come in for food. And notice that they just hit the diver. He's shaking his head and he's trying to clear his mask because that last shark almost knocked off his mask. So now we're just about at the end of the shark dive. He's almost run out of food, and you're going to see in just a little bit a shark with a big fish hook in its mouth. That shark had a fish hook in its mouth, and now he's going to empty the bait can, and it causes a crazy commotion in the water, and that's it.